Junie B. Jones and the Yucky Blucky Fruitcake. Chapter 7, Winning. Room 9 looked very fun. Music was playing in that place, and children were marching in a circle. They were stepping on big squares of paper with numbers on them. "That's the cakewalk," Mother explained. "You walk around in a circle until the lady stops the music. Then she pulls a number out of a hat. And if you're standing on the square with the same number, you win a cake." Mother pointed to a table with cakes on it. "See all the delicious cakes you have to choose from?" she said. I looked at all the delicious cakes. Then my mouth got very watering, and I did a little bit of a drool on myself. All of a sudden, the music stopped, and all of the children stopped too. The cake lady reached into a hat. She pulled out a number. "Number 5," she said very loud. "Hey, that's me! I'm on 5," shouted a boy with red hair. Then he ran right to the cake table and picked out a chocolate one for his prize. "Oh, yum," I said. "This looks like the most delicious game I ever saw." I gave the cake lady my ticket. "Guess what?" I said. "This is my last chance to win a prize. Except for I won a comb, and I also got to throw a sponge at a kid I hate. Plus, I jumped till sweat came on my head. But then I couldn't find my shoe named Leather, and so that's how come I have a sock foot." The lady looked funny at me. "Yes, well, good luck to you," she said. "Good luck to you too," I said back. Then I skipped very fast to the squares with the numbers on them. "Okay, ready anytime you are," I yelled. But the cake lady kept on waiting and waiting for other kids to come. It took a very long time. That's how come I got ants in my pants. I did huffing and puffing, then I folded my arms, and I tapped my foot very fast. "Hey, I'm not getting any younger over here," I shouted. Finally, the cake lady clapped her hands. "Boys and girls, I'm going to start the music now, and I would like you to march in an orderly circle. But remember, as soon as the music stops, you stop too." After that, she turned the music way loud. I did my best as marching. My feet were very bouncing, and my knees went way high in the air. Then all of a sudden, just like before, the music stopped, and all the children stopped too. The cake lady reached into her hat. "Number 3, she hollered out. I looked down at my square. "Hey, it's me! It's me! Look, I'm standing on the number 3, and so I'm the winner, I think." Mother clapped her hands. "It is you. You are the winner," she yelled and had relief on her face. "Go pick out a cake, any cake you want," she said. I zoomed to the cake table and looked at all the yummy flavors. There was chocolate and orange and lemon and white and coconutty and cupcakes and donuts and brownies. Also, there was a secret cake wrapped in shiny aluminum foil. "What kind is that one?" I asked. The cake lady wrinkled her nose. "Oh, I don't think you want that one. That one is a fruit cake," she said. I smiled real big. "Yeah?" I hollered. "Yeah, for the delicious fruit cake, because fruit cake is the best thing I love, and so that's the one I pick." Mother shook her head. "No, Junie B, it's not the kind of fruit you think it is. You're not gonna like it." I stopped smiling. "Yeah, only that is not fair and square of you, because you said I could pick any cake I wanted, and now I picked the fruit cake, and you say I can't have it." Mother rolled her eyes up at the ceiling. "Fine, take the fruit cake," she grouched. She lifted it off the table for me. "No, me, I want to carry it," I hollered. "It's very heavy," said Mother. "Yeah, only that's how come I have muscly muscles in my arms," I explained. I bended my arm to show her. See my muscle bump? That's how strong I am." Finally, Mother put the cake in my arms, and it dropped on the floor. "Whoa," I said. "This is the strongest fruit I ever felt." "Now do you want me to carry it?" Mother asked. "No," I said, because I just got a great idea in my head. Then I put my heavy cake of fruit down on the floor, and I dragged it right out of room 9.